Halo Marketeers, kita kembali lagi di program Katakan Dengan Data. Program ini mengupas satu industri dalam perspektif data. Dan pada kesempatan kali ini kita akan membahas tentang consumer health industry. Kita akan berbicara tentang produk-produk kesehatan, terutama obat-obatan, dan bagaimana trennya di Indonesia saat ini. With me today, we have Pak Jowel Tacata from IQVIA Indonesia. Hello, Pak.
Hello, hello, Pak Iwan, and thanks for having me.
How are you, Pak?
I'm good. The year is almost ending. Things are really moving very fast, but we're getting there.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming to our studio today. We have some questions about the industry overall, the consumer health industry. What are the top products in Indonesia today in terms of sales for consumer health?
Correct. So things are still, you know, when you look at the big categories, they're still the same, right? You have your vitamins and tonics, you have cough and cold, pain relief, you have cough syrup, cold remedies. So they will still be on the top of the list, but you know, during the pandemic, a lot of things have changed the trends within these categories, right? So vitamins, for example, has really shoot up. There's really a big spike as a result of the pandemic.
People want to build immunity.
People want to build, and they're also more aware of the health, becoming more health conscious, doing self-preventive medication, right? So I think that remains to be a good indicator of what's to come.
Yeah.
And we just see now the market is normalizing actually.
Right. Yeah. Is that the fastest growing category, or is it something else?
Yeah.
What's the fastest?
So it's a good question. The pandemic has really change some of the dynamics, right? But post-pandemic, let's say for vitamins, we are seeing a plateau.
Okay.
We're seeing it really normalizing.
Okay.
And then you're seeing the other categories like pain relief, cough and cold remedies starting to bounce back.
Okay.
Right. And the reason for that, of course, is that you now have more consumers.
Right.
Not less stocking the products,
Okay.
Because now you're free to move. You're now able to do
the mobility is coming.
Mobility is
back.
There, so you don't really need to, to panic in terms of buying
stock
and stocking
stuff.
Correct.
I understand. Yeah. Okay. So where do people buy these medications or products?
Well, you have different channels, obviously. Yeah. You can go to what we call the modern trade. These are your supermarkets, groceries, the general trade. But the main channel is really the pharmacy.
The
apotheks.
The apotheks.
These are really growing very fast, especially in the consumer health. So it's becoming really very, again, back to the influence is back, Of course, there were online channels before, but again, because of the mobility, then you have more pharmacies becoming the biggest chain.
Wow. Yeah. So the contribution is 40% plus?
Exactly, around that figure.
Around that figure.
Yeah.
So pharmacy is still very dominant in terms
of yeah.
channel. What's the second most important channel?
Well, depends on the category,
yeah.
but you will have your modern trade and the general trade, right?
Okay.
That will be your next categories. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. In terms of the brands or the companies producing these products, is it more domestic companies, like Indonesian-based companies, or more of MNCs?
Well, in this part of the world, the local companies, the domestic companies, are really dominating.
Oh, really?
They're about 70% of the market, right? And it's not because there's just a lot of them in numbers. Actually, it's very concentrated. And most of these companies are really very good companies as well, right? You look at these domestic companies and innovating. That's why they're able to compete head-to-head with the brands coming from the multinationals.
Okay, so the product quality is
there.
Equal.
There's there's science that comes into the it comes into the messaging, right? Even I think to a certain extent, you know, in ahead in terms of
even ahead.
reaching to direct to the consumers,
right? Okay.
In some ways.
And probably the relationship with the channel also better, maybe.
And that's exactly what I'm saying.
Okay, so you know, reaching out to the people who actually purchase the product, the channels.
A lot of these companies have are vertically integrated.
Yes.
You know, they also have a chain of pharmacy under the umbrella.
Right. So it's within
the business, within the journey. So they are able to capitalize on that. Unlike a multinational, for example, where you really need to look at connecting the different supply chain.
You need have to partner with a lot of different companies.
Exactly. Yeah. Correct.
Interesting. I think I know the companies that you're thinking.
Yeah, they will be in the top ones.
Yeah.
Correct.
Is it also because the pricing is more value for money?
Yeah. I mean, it has always been you know, a price driven market in Indonesia because you have more you know, local players, right? And you have, you know, a bigger population at the mass level, right? But it doesn't necessarily mean that all of these categories, you know, especially if you look at the top five, are really driven by price, right?
Okay.
So take vitamins, for example, right? Because of the pandemic, you now have more patients looking for more quality and, consumers, right?
Consumers.
They really the self-awareness, it's an all-time high, right? And they really know what they want.
Yes.
And they look for it, you know, they search for it online. And these are the shall we say the middle to upper class segment. And that's actually half of the market for vitamins. So there's really a place for mid to premium pricing.
Okay, so vitamins around half is actually premium segment.
Yes, mid to premium.
Mid to premium. Yeah. So it's dominated by high quality products.
High quality products, correct.
And people don't think too much about pricing in that category.
At least half of them.
At least half of them.
Half of them. They just look for quality.
They look for the best.
Yeah, but it doesn't mean, you know, the lower segments are lesser of a quality, but it's more in terms of the perception.
The perception
Of the consumers, and it's since it's more mass based, then you don't really get to have more, you know, recall promotion.
The image is just not.
It's not at par. Correct.
It's not at par. But the quality is probably not really different.
Not really different.
Not really different. Yeah, yeah.
That's
less significant.
Exactly.
So, other than vitamins. The rest of the top categories are mostly still price sensitive.
Yes, still price sensitive. What it means is that you have a bigger segment of the consumer, which is more conscious. It's probably about, you know, between 70 to 80% are really very price conscious.
Okay.
Right. But for, you know, vitamins as a category, we found out, at least from our research, that it's half of that. Is very potential for premium.
So, Pajo, what's the key success factor for companies that produces consumer health products to win the Indonesian market?
That's really a very good question, especially with you know, leading the leaders now within the consumer health industry, right? So there are a couple of things there, right? I think number one is the preparedness to reboot, you know.
I see.
After the pandemic, you really need to, you know, rethink on the strategies, right? And we've seen that companies who are more prepared, you know, are doing well. It means that they were prepared prior to the pandemic, their capabilities accelerated, and then post-pandemic, they were really the very first to bounce back.
I see.
Right? That's yeah. The first. The second would be, we always hear about this digital, all of this digital transformation. Mm-hmm. That will still really be a key success factor.
Right.
So companies really need to have a very clear digital strategy, you know, either content, platform, going to the consumers. Right. There has to be a continuous and sustained consciousness from the companies to have that. The third factor would be, you know, the overall adaptability, agility of the company for the changing market situation. So
yes.
One of those would be, you know, a very well informed consumer market, right? So they have to really be prepared on how they will be able to connect to this type of consumers. That's
right.
One. Second is looking at, you know, again, the adoption to different type of channels.
Right? Right.
You will be, of course, we talk about digital, but there are also like all this e-commerce, telemedicine, teleconsultation.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to, again, be prepared on how to be, well adept.
Right? Mm-hmm.
The others would be looking at the relationship among the different key stakeholders,
right.
Key players within the industry, right? If a company has a aspiration also to go abroad, then it further changes the dynamics, right? I think the last part, which is I think the most important part, would be the people component.
Mm.
Again, you really need to have very well trained workplace and able to accommodate different ideas from different segments, you know. Your book, for example, talks about different generations within the workplace.
Right, right.
That needs a very good understanding within the organization, because they will be driving the initiatives, right?
Right.
Some will be leading it, some will be driving it, right? And there has to be a very good balance within the different generations in the workplace.
Right. So, in essence, we have to be very adaptive to the new environment, post-pandemic,
correct.
Digitalization and the new segment emerging,
correct,
and so on. Thank you so much, Pak Jowel. We'll be having a second episode after this episode that talks about the post-pandemic consumer health industry. Thank you so much, Pak.
Thank you.